Not real common in the desert regions to have ticks in your yard, especially in the summertime. Typically what will happen is an adult tick will climb onto a host and feed for a couple of days. Then they'll find another tick on the host, mate, and then they drop off after mating and lay eggs. And the packets of eggs that they lay are between 5,000 and 10,000.
What?
Per tick. Yeah.
That's disgusting.
So what happens then is those eggs will lay dormant for anywhere from 3 weeks to 3 months, depending on environmental conditions, and then they'll hatch. And the first stage of hatching is the tick is going to have only 6 legs instead of 8, and they're called larvae, even though they don't look like larvae. They look like small brown ticks, and I think your son said he'd seen some of those small brown ticks.
We found a few small. We found one or two small.
We found some yesterday too.
So the larva will then attach to a host. They can wait up to 3 months before attaching without eating, just in wait. And then when they find a host, they'll attach onto pant legs or shoes or fur, and they'll feed on the host. Then they'll drop off again and molt in a corner behind a baseboard or up in furniture somewhere to an adult tick. After they drop off and lay eggs somewhere in the house or in the fence line, or usually it's in a hidden location, not out in the open, they die. And those eggs then go through a process of hatching 5,000 to 10,000 little nymphs, those little tiny ones that you never see because they don't really, they're not very obvious, especially with brown carpet. Then they'll end up climbing up onto a host. They can detect hosts through carbon dioxide that we exhale, through movement, through shadows. If they're outside, they can actually move towards a host, towards your leg, or towards an animal through shadows. The sun, they can tell the gradient. They can't run, jump, or fly, so they just kind of hang out until something brushes up against them. So that's just to understand the life cycle of the tick and how we're going to treat for it. We need to treat all the surfaces of your home where they can be, and then we're going to need to come back in about 30 days and do another application. We don't want to use anything inside your home that's going to be dangerous to you or your family. So it needs to sort of denigrate, it needs to break down. So the tick's life cycle is longer than the chemical can actually act for. That's why you're going to have several treatments to get rid of this problem. Some of these ticks could be behind baseboards in your home, and so there'll be a series of treatments. But as long as you have the dogs treated when we treat, or if you treat them yourselves, you're going to be able to break this cycle. You're going to be able to take care of it.